Feed your brain with the info you need to start your day.
Good morning, world. It's a brand new day.
This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton on 103.7 WTIB and 94.1 WNBU.
Oh, my.
I think we should, Michael, you should start taping the conversation that goes on in this studio.
No.
During the news
I don't
break.
Have enough time on the dump.
Play, yeah, our ratings would go up exponentially.
Fine.
So people would be afraid not to listen. Of course, the FCC would throw us off the air. But welcome back to Hour 2 of Talk of the Town, Monday, May 16th. Trent McGee is here in the Hizzle. How are you?
I'm
nice
well.
Nice to see you. And Matt Engelbrecht, who was with his dog, Isobars, over the weekend.
Wow.
What was the name of the dog?
Proudy. I'll take Isobars. It's really Flurry.
I'm sorry, the dog's name is Flurry.
That's impressive.
I think Isobars would have been a better name for the dog.
I'm really surprised you pulled Isobars out.
Come here, Isobars.
What is good. An isobar, by the way?
It's a pressure. Line of equal pressure.
Michael, is anybody talking to you? I'm talking to the meteorologist here.
Hey, I know about meteorology a little bit.
I know about meteorology.
Look, I'm asking Matt a meteorology question, and Michael chimes in, pressure.
That's what it is.
He knew about geography last week.
That's right.
Now he's a meteorologist.
Yeah. That's right.
Michael, stay out of this.
We're in geography.
I'm talking to my meteorologist here. I'm having therapy with a meteorologist.
Yes.
So you named your dog, what did you name him? Backdraft?
Flurry.
Flurry.
I don't know how many times we have to go over this.
Flurry. You know what my lawyer named his dog? My lawyer in
Sue
Raleigh.
Me.
No. Sue me? No.
That's a good one.
He named his dog Loophole.
Oh, that's even better. Loophole.
I get it.
That's good. See? Great minds think alike.
People name that's their good. Dogs crazy stuff.
That's great. And boats.
You remember the story about when Terry and Ann Holland had a dog when Terry was the head coach at Virginia?
Oh, yeah.
And Dean Smith, and he used to have epic battles.
Yeah.
And so when Terry, so they named their dog Dean. And they asked Terry why. They said because he whines all the time.
That's funny. That's a classic story.
Terry now swears he didn't say that. I think he said it.
I think it's a great story.
I think he said it.
Just think if you named your dog after your profession, you know, that'd be pretty funny. You know, you could name yours Mike.
Oh, Mike. That would be boring.
You know, like right, Mike.
I think I should just name him Transmitter Tube.
Yeah, that's a better name for it.
Yeah, that flows well. That's an easy one to say. Put that one on the leash.
Michael, what would you name your dog? Nerdlinger?
Well, tax exempt.
Tax exempt. There you go. Tax write off.
Michael would name his dog Deduction.
There we go. That dog owns a lot of stuff, let me tell you.
All right, it's 8 minutes after 8 o'clock. Come here, Deduction. Sunny and 71 today. What's happening with the weather, Matt? Because we seem to, I mean, Saturday was like a world-class mid-May day.
Wasn't good.
And then all of a sudden it got chilly at night, and now it's going to rain all week. Is that pretty much right?
That's accurate. Yeah, rinse and repeat, like what we had last week. You know, 3 or 4 days where we had those scattered showers. Latest, I was just looking at it like 2 hours ago. One of the models is spitting out a low-pressure system coming up on Saturday and Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
So, worth keeping an eye on. That's what we're going to be watching.
There you go.
Yeah.
A lot to get to this hour, McGee. East Carolina with a little are we considering this weekend a little bit of a toe stumper?
I would say so. That's my opinion.
Because South Florida is like one of the worst teams in the conference.
They are, however. They have played a lot of league games. They've had a lot of close league games, I should say. In fact, going into Friday's game with ECU, they had lost 4 conference games by just 1 run. And so they've been, and these were series winning, potentially series clinching games. So they've been on the verge of winning series, and they had just won. In fact, they hadn't won a series all season long until this one. This was their first series win.
Wow, that's
but it
bad.
Goes to show you how close we were winning the series.
So that's what I drives think you better. Crazy about baseball.
Yeah, it does. It does. But I do think ECU certainly with the comeback Friday night, which was spectacular, being down what they were and then to score 9 runs in the 6th inning was phenomenal. I felt pretty good about them going into Saturday and Sunday. They were gonna at least win the series. To lose 2, I was surprised by that.
And Matt was over there with his dog Weather Map.
No, Flurry.
Flurry.
It's Flurry.
So how did they look on Saturday? What happened on Saturday? Because yesterday they lost by 1 run.
6-5. Yeah.
They only scored in 1 inning. They had 5 runs in the 2nd inning. They didn't score any other inning.
Well, they tied it up on Saturday. It was 1-1 going to the top of the 9th, and then there was a 3-run bomb. I think it was 3. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 3-run shot to center field. The guy blasted the ball.
So, Campbell tomorrow night to close things out.
This is the last home game of the year, right?
Unless
we host a regional.
Which is not going to happen. They're not going to host a regional.
Why? Because of the transgender bathrooms?
It could be an issue. You may see teams choose not to come to Greenville because of that. Yeah. No.
Are you being ridiculous?
No, you are with saying that. That was ridiculous. No, they're not going to host a regional. No.
But you just don't think we'll get a regional?
Mm-mm. I do think they will be in a regional, yes, and right now.
Well, what if we win the conference? I mean, we could still win outright the conference. Regular season and the conference tournament. So we still would get the host of regional?
Conference tournament, better shot at winning that one than the regular season. I don't see anybody overtaking Tulane for the top spot. And of course, they have the tiebreaker.
We're only a game and a half out.
I know.
But there's only 1 weekend left,
I know.
Right?
I just don't think they're going to host a regional. I really don't. I mean, if you look at, again, their projections, but a lot of, Clemson and or NC State, one of those 2 regionals I can see.
How many wins do we have now?
Like 31.
31, yeah. 31. They're kind of on the bubble for hosting.
31. Yeah. And UCF is a team that, they go right back to UCF after this series this weekend for the tournament. They need this one. They need this game tomorrow night, and they need to take 2 or 3 from UCF to really position themselves to get either a 2 or 3 seed in the regional. I would not like them going into the regional as a 4 seed and having to play that top seed.
There's a 60% chance of rain tomorrow night. Are we going to get this game in tomorrow night? I want to take my grandson to the game tomorrow night. No.
I think so. Yeah, you might want to bring a poncho just in case. I'm not seeing anything that would cause it to be canceled, like lightning or severe weather or anything like that, but sort of light rain is going to be possible.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, good 12 minutes after 8 o'clock. Let's get some news. Are you ready for news? I got a lot of people to talk to this hour. You want to do your news?
Yeah, of course.
Matty Ice is here with our WITN News Update. Good morning, Matt.
Good morning. Time now, 8:12 on this Monday. Latest news headlines from WITN, WITN.com. Watching a few stories. One breaking this morning. A woman is being treated for what authorities call a life-threatening injuries after being thrown from her car during a crash this morning. Officials in Greene County say the wreck on Highway 258 near the intersection of Tyson Chapel Church Road near the Pitt County line happened when a woman in her 30s ran off the road in her SUV, hit a ditch, and rotated. The woman was thrown out of the back of the car, according to authorities on the scene. Another driver called 911. The woman was taken to Vidant Medical Center. Her name has not been released. The wreck was slowing traffic on Highway 258 at the Greenville-Pitt County line earlier this morning. However, both lanes of traffic are open once again now that crews have cleared the scene. Police in Martin County, in a Martin County town, needed the help of several law enforcement agencies to defuse multiple fights in a crowd of roughly 3,000 Sunday night. Robertsonville Police Chief Philip Lee says officers were called to the Newtown area around 8 p.m. He says several fights broke out at once. As officers weeded through the group of thousands to identify those in the wrong, Lee says they did not see any weapons and did not spray anyone or use taser guns. The people had gathered for the Remembering the Elks event. Lee says while there were some troublemakers there, the vast majority of people were not violating any laws. He described it as chaotic and, quote, a close call. No charges had been filed as of Sunday evening. The investigation obviously continues. And finally, hundreds mourn the life of a beloved volunteer fireman this past weekend. Jay Tyndall, a 45-year-old volunteer fireman, was honored and celebrated Sunday at a funeral service in Lenoir County. Hugo Volunteer Fire Department Chief Johnny Kraft says Tyndall died from a brain aneurysm that developed soon after he responded to a fire call last Sunday night. Kraft says Tyndall died Thursday at Duke Hospital. A funeral was held in Deep Run at the Church of Jesus Christ Latter-day Saints, where family, friends, and fellow firemen acknowledged his joy, passion, and love of helping others. He worked with the Hugo Volunteer Fire Department since August 2014 and had intentions of becoming state certified. Those are the latest news headlines from WI10, WI10.com. Time now on this Monday, 8:14. I'm Ed Ingber.
Oh, yes. I was waiting for the weather jingle. Eastern Carolina. Sing it for me, Miguel. Weather. Do that again, McGee.
Doom, 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 doom. Eastern Carolina weather.
I just wanted to see if he'd do it again.
Oh, yeah, I'll do it again.
Yeah. Don't ever do it again. Here is the forecast for today. We got sunshine at 71. We're looking for cloudy and 57 tonight. And then on Tuesday, we're looking for high temperatures to get a little warmer, 77, but a 60% chance of rain creeping into the forecast. Wednesday, cloudy and 76. Chance of rain is 50%. And the current temperature right now, about 52 degrees. Is that right?
Yeah, it's going up a little bit.
News and weather, a service this hour of the Tire Realty Group and Property Management Team. The home of the new 99-day guarantee. If you hadn't heard about this, all you do, if you list your home with Homer Tire and the agents of the Tire Realty Group, you list it, sell it, and move on with Tire Realty Group. Tire Realty will guarantee to sell your home in 99 days, or they put their money where their mouth is, and they will then sell it for free. How many other agents are willing to put their paycheck on the line? So it's sold in 99 days, or it's free. And right now, Tire Property Management's also looking to hire a full-time property manager to assist with all the new rentals they have coming on the market. So if you or someone you know is interested in learning more about this opportunity, contact them today at the Tire Realty Group at 758-4663, 758-4663, or you can visit them online at 99orfree.com. That's the website, 99orfree.com. Be like this couple in Greenville, Shelby and Turk, who were tired of messing around when it came to selling their home in Greenville. They had been on the market with another realtor for over 280 days with no results. So they call Homer Tire, and the Tire Realty Group has an aggressive marketing system that outperforms all others. They sold Shelby and Turk's home in 30 days with the help of Tire Realty Group. Now that's what I call results. Call them today at 758-HOME, 758-4663. All right, 17 after 8 o'clock. It is 8:17. More Talk of the Town coming up for Monday morning, May the 16th. Stay with us.
That's right, folks. There's a brand new beautiful dealership on Highway 264 in Washington. The City of Washington now has a new dealership focused on making your experience as comfortable and easy as possible. For the best price, selection, service, and a great customer experience, stop in to see us at the beautiful new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 in Washington and visit WashingtonChrysler.com.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
There's a new name in convenience in Eastern North Carolina. All Wilco Hess stores are now Speedway. What makes Speedway different? They understand people's needs. There are many choices out there, but Speedway recognizes that nothing less than outstanding service, a wide selection of products, and a real value for your dollar will attract loyal customers. More than anything, Speedway offers convenience. Come see us at Speedway, serving 22 states in the U.S. and now proud to serve the communities right here in Eastern North Carolina.
During Greenville Toyota's Memorial Markdown Madness, we're giving you more. More selection, more for your trade, more savings. Don't miss our Memorial Day Markdown Madness all month long. At Greenville Toyota, give us 15 minutes, we can lower your payment.
Friday morning will be our annual Crime Stoppers telethon, radiothon. We raise money for the Greenville Pitt County Crime Stoppers. They got their big golf tournament coming up too, which we'll be promoting. I think those folks will be on the show tomorrow. But the we'll be at Krispy Kreme coming up on Friday morning, and we always encourage people, particularly businesses in Greenville and Pitt County, to plan a little something, a little donation for the Crime Stoppers folks. This is the money they use to dole out to get information to solve crimes, and it's a proven winner. It's been proven time and time again that this program works, and it works well. So plan to be with us on Friday morning at Krispy Kreme. We'll be down there live. We'll be collecting money for Crime Stoppers. And by the way, you'll get a free donut as well. So that's Friday morning. Coming up on Saturday night in Edenton is going to be a fundraiser for a young man, a young man's family who passed away. Chris Williams is the person that I'm talking about here. My friend Charles Britton, that I grew up with in Edenton, is on the telephone. Charles is in a gospel group called Just in Time, and they are having a fundraiser for this young man's family coming up. Charles, good morning. How are you?
Good morning, Henry. How are you doing today?
What's happening in God's country? Tell me it's beautiful in Edenton this morning.
Right now the sun is shining, just a little bit of dew, and God's country is looking great. Nice blue, light blue sky.
Walk down to the waterfront for me this morning since I can't do it. Take a picture and send it to me.
I'll do it for you.
Tell me about Chris Williams. This is a tragic story of this young man who passed away at age 39 with a family. Tell me about Chris.
He's my nephew, and he lives out here where we do on 17, out by what we call the 5 mile wide, headed to Hereford. He would have been 40 in November, and he passed away November the 3rd, and he left a 5, 9, and 11-year-old, two girls and a boy.
Wow.
And we're just trying to raise some money to help his fiance who's left. And, you know, she's just got a big burden, and the town is really coming together to raise some money and help these people.
So this is going to happen on Saturday night at the Albemarle Baptist Church at 7 o'clock. And so it's a fundraiser, but your singing group will be there. You've been in a gospel group for a long time up there, Just in Time. That's the entertainment? Is that what you're doing?
Yes, sir. We're singing. We've also got Miss Sarah Hardison of Hardison's Barbecue in Janesville. She'll be singing, a talented young gospel singer, and also a local talent, Adam Nixon, who has done several things with a former friend of mine, Martin Parker. Mm. He's also going to be singing, and we're going to have a silent auction also at the same time.
Because we lost Martin last year, which we've talked about here on the show. I had a great interview with Martin right before he died, bless his heart, who, of course, was a great drummer and performed for many, many years with Vince Gill and Linda Lovelace and some other great people in Nashville, and we lost Martin last year too, so that's a tough situation. How can people help with this fundraiser for Chris Williams' family?
Well, we've got a thing set up with the State Employees Credit Union in Edenton that they can send checks to Ken Williams and then put care of Chris Williams' family on the bottom. The account's already set up. They can send the check to me, Charles Britton, 1739 Ocean Highway, and I'll make sure they get it. We're taking donations. We've had Colony Tire, Sears, Nixon's Catering, Byron Gift Shop, everybody in town, Kim's Floors. They're donating items to be auctioned off. We've got Decoys Handmade. 31 Club is sending stuff. And we've just been blessed with the community coming together. And, you know, we're blessed with having a friend like you that would actually put this on the air so people can hear about it.
Charles, it's a tragedy, but, you know, hopefully something good will come out of this. How do you make checks out for this?
It's made out to Kenneth Williams, and then on the bottom left of your check, down at, you just put it for Chris Williams' family. And you can send it to State Employees Credit Union in Eatonton, and it will go into an account set up for the children.
Well, you're great to do this, and sorry to hear this news about Chris Williams and the family that are left behind. It's always a tragedy when these kind of things happen, but it's good to have friends like you and family that will step up and help. So thank you for what you're doing on this, my friend.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much for putting this on the air.
All right, Charles, nice talking to you. We'll talk to you soon.
Have a blessed day.
Same to you. Charles Britton, my friend up in Eatonton, North Carolina. 26 minutes after 8 o'clock, let's get a break in, and we'll be back with more Talk of the Town here on Monday morning, May 16th.
Make Speedway different? They understand people's needs. There are many choices out there, but Speedway recognizes that nothing less than outstanding service, a wide selection of products, and a real value for your dollar will attract loyal customers. More than anything, Speedway offers convenience. Come see us at Speedway, serving 22 states in the U.S. and now proud to serve the communities right here in Eastern North Carolina.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is now open. That's right, folks. There's a brand new beautiful dealership on Highway 264 in Washington. The city of Washington now has a new dealership focused on making your experience as comfortable and easy as possible. For the best price, selection, service, and a great customer experience, stop in to see us at the beautiful new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 in Washington and visit WashingtonChrysler.com.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Hi, this is Pirate Baseball Coach Cliff Godwin. I drive the most awarded SUV of all time, the Jeep Grand Cherokee. It's great for short trips to the ballpark or long trips on the recruiting trail. Chip Davis and the staff at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep always take great care of me in the service department. If you need a new car, truck, or SUV, these guys knock it out of the park every single time. For the best price, service, and selection,
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Every time I look into your loving eyes.
All right, welcome back. It's 8:30 here on Monday morning, and Mike Godwin has joined us. Mike's the aquatic supervisor for Greenville Aquatics and Fitness Center, and he's here to tell us about a big day coming up on Saturday.
Absolutely.
How are you?
Doing well.
Good
doing
to
well.
See you.
Good to see you, too.
Everything going well at the aquatic center?
We are just as busy as can be right now.
Yeah, I guess so, with summer camps coming up and things like that. You were telling me all your summer camps are full.
Yeah, summer camp is full, and we're booked up on swim lessons and swim clubs all the way till about the middle of July.
Oh, my goodness. Well, my grandson's been taking swim lessons out there for a couple of years, and he loves it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Great facility that we have here. A lot of people don't know about it because it's not right in the center of town, but... Well, you know, for folks who don't, you've got a great opportunity this Saturday to come learn what goes on there, right?
Exactly. We're hosting our Family Fun Day, which is essentially like an open house.
Yeah.
It's going to showcase a lot of the services and the programs we provide. It's 10 to 2 this Saturday. Lots of things going on. We're going to do arts and crafts with the kids. We're going to have some of our aqua classes, karate demonstrations, small group training, which is very popular right now, pickleball and badminton, which is... you know, spans a lot of ages. And then we're also offering free one-on-one swim evaluations for kids, for adults. One of the things I can tell you from teaching for 10 to 15 years myself, that it is very helpful to your instructor if you know what your kids can do in the water. It mm-hmm. helps us place them so much better.
Right, right. So this is like the day to come out and learn everything there is to know about the aquatic center here in town.
Absolutely. Completely open to the public. All of the things I just mentioned, completely free. Come out, try them, see if you like it. You know, you can do a sampling throughout the day. We've got a schedule that's on the website and on Facebook. Kind of look at what we've got. Come in, try some things you've never done before.
Yeah. So, McGee, so when Mike came in, I said, how's your pickleball going? And he said, their program's really picked up and they've got a big pickle. I said, you know, I need to try that because I've heard it's a great game for fat old people to play. Thinking that Mike would say something like, oh, you're not fat and old. And he said, yes, you should come try it.
It's a great game for anyone to play, honestly. It is one of our most popular programs right now.
I was going to say, pickleball has like swept the nation, right?
It was a very
Who knew?
Yeah, it was a foreign word when it came in. We were like, what is pickleball? I mean, just the name of it sounds kind of weird, but it has really picked up. We have people that just come into the facility just for that activity.
Yeah, I actually was over there one day picking my grandson up from swimming, and I watched people playing in there. And I thought, I could do that.
Absolutely. It looks like a giant ping pong, basically.
Yeah. All right, so Family Fun Day coming up Saturday, starting at 10 o'clock?
10 o'clock in the morning, running all the way to 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
So it's 4 hours, 10 to 2, Greenville yes. Aquatics and Fitness Center. And it's Family Fun Day, a lot of great things for the kids. Come on out and enjoy the Aquatic Center and find out what's available here as part of the Greenville Parks and Recreation Department with
That's
our
right.
aquatics program. Sounds good. What's the website if people want to learn more?
You can find us on greenvillenc.gov. Just go on there, and it's pretty easy to find the Aquatic Center. You can also find us on Facebook through the Greenville Recreation and Parks page.
All right, great. Thanks for coming by. Good
Thank
to see
you so
Thank
much.
You, man. Mike Godwin from the Greenville Aquatics and Fitness Center here in Greenville. Family Fun Day coming up this weekend. All right, 27 in front of 9. We've got McGee in sports next.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is now open. That's right, folks. There's a brand new beautiful dealership on Highway 264 in Washington, The City of Washington now has a new dealership focused on making your experience as comfortable and easy as possible. For the best price, selection, service, and a great customer experience, stop in to see us at the beautiful new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 in Washington and visit WashingtonChrysler.com.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Being undaunted is not something ECU fans take lightly. It means never taking a day or season off from showing their true pirate passion through thick and thin. It means gathering to celebrate and cheer the Pirates to victory regardless of life's trials and tribulations. And it means welcoming all types, seasoned veterans to new grads, into the crew to discover the successes ahead. Join the undaunted on the 2016 journey by purchasing your East Carolina football season tickets at ecupirates.com.
Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
In front of 9 o'clock, up to 54 degrees here in Greenville, and the high temperature today, 71, so a little warmer, a little cooler, rather, than it was Saturday. About like yesterday. Yesterday was a good day, too. I played golf yesterday. I guess you could call what I played golf, McGee. I had the worst round of golf in probably 30 years yesterday.
You know, those days happen. It's golf.
I keep told
it's like you said with baseball. It's baseball. It's golf.
So I'm playing with a couple of good friends of mine that you know well, who are more than happy to continue to take my money. And I keep telling myself, this is just a little phase you're going through. You're going to get better. Your swing's going to get better. You're going to play better. And so I kept doubling the bet.
And it kept getting worse.
And they were more than happy to. Continue to suck up my cash.
I've been there.
I didn't do well yesterday.
You tend to play better when I play in a group that is with you or nearby you. And when I don't, every time I don't play with you and you play over the weekend, you play bad.
I played terrible. I didn't par a hole until the 16th hole. That's how bad I played.
I'm not going to ask.
That's
you
how
you
bad
shot.
I played. I'm not going to tell you what I shot. It's embarrassing. Embarrassing, but there are a couple of friends of mine who were more than willing to take my money, and you know I thought it was quite uncharitable.
It always is,
and I will never forget
when
that
you're on the losing end, payback giving in,
payback is hell. But I can tell you, until I get a golf lesson, there won't be any payback.
That's what I've been saying all year. I mean, have a golf lesson, see how it goes.
It's time to get a lesson before I start talking about payback.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Do you see this sports reporter in Washington, D.C. that got drunk on the air?
Heard about this guy, yeah. I heard him.
This guy was mad that the Stanley Cup team, that the Capitals lost the last week in the Stanley Cup playoffs. His name is Michael Jenkins. He's one of the TV stations in D.C. This is what it sounded like. he reached down and picked up a glass from the floor and started drinking on the air.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Geico Sportsnet Central. Always great to have you with us here at CSN. I'm Michael Jenkins. You guys hear about the Caps? No? You like to drink? I like to drink. I'm going to drink the whole show. Got a message for all you kids out there. I know everyone says, oh, you can do whatever you want if you put your mind to it. It's all one big lie. Caps were supposed to win it all this season. They put their mind to it. Look what happened. Crushing disappointment. So, give up on your dreams. With each passing week, it seems like Stephen Curry continues to write the NBA record books. Then again, it must be easy when you've already won a championship, you know?
Chuck. I got out of hand.
So that's the crew going chuck.
So apparently the entire crew,
I guess,
was
everybody
drunk.
Was in on it.
So
I guess everybody was in on it.
That was pretty good, though.
That was not legit, was it?
No, don't believe so.
It was supposed to be a. I'm surprised the management of the station let him get away with it, but I clearly.
Yeah, well, he said, you know, I actually heard him on the Dan Patrick Show on 94.3 The Game, and he was talking about everybody thinking it was going to be funny, and they agreed with it because Dan Patrick asked him, you know, just what you said, management let you get away with this? They were okay with you drink, you know, pretending to drink on the air? And he said, oh, yeah, they thought it'd be funny. You know, we've done this kind of thing before. So.
So he was on Dan Patrick's show?
Oh, yeah. Patrick had him on. Sure did.
Oh, man.
Yep.
We haven't played any late night this morning. Last couple of tonight's shows, Jimmy Fallon's had some good Donald Trump material.
Speaking of Trump, in a recent interview, he said that he's hoping to make the Republican National Convention more fun by hiring some entertainment. Which is confusing for a lot of people because they thought Donald Trump was the entertainment. They go, no. You get that right. In a New York Times interview yesterday, Donald Trump compared his candidacy to both Broadway shows and baseball. Yeah, because both start off really fun and end with half the people saying, wait, is this still going on? Is it over? I gotta get out of here, man. I hate to break it to Trump, but there's already a Broadway show called Hairspray. So,
Hairspray.
Oh. The big story is that today was the long-awaited meeting between Donald Trump and Speaker of the House, Paul Ryan. Or as Trump put it, this guy only has one house, Sav. It's at least three houses.
That was Thursday night. That was Thursday night. So we've got some more stuff here. Hang on a second. Be right with you in a second. Don't go away.
Standing by.
Be right.
Standing by.
This was before the story broke about Donald Trump pretending to be his, when he was talking to the reporter and saying that he was Trump's press agent, but it was really him.
That story is just very, very bizarre. Bizarre is an understatement.
The question that I have is, why would he want that out? I don't really get that.
Good question.
Here's Jimmy Fallon from Friday night.
The election is all anyone's talking about, and this week the billionaire T. Boone Pickens weighed in, and he's praising Donald Trump's success in business as an indication of his good economic policies and said, quote, you judge a trapper by his pelt. Trump was like, for the last time, it's not a pelt, it's my hair, okay? Down, boy. Sit down. Sit. Be quiet. Okay, boy. Get this, an artist is hoping to protest the Republican National Convention in Cleveland by having 100 women pose nude outside the event. Or as Republican men put it, hey, no, stop.
Jimmy Fallon from Friday night. Yeah, okay. All right, 8:43, 17 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. Time for some sports headlines now. Here with the very latest, here's McGee on sports.
Right,
and he is not drinking this morning.
No, I'm not.
Just coffee, I think.
That's all it is. ECU baseball from the weekend. South Florida took the series from the Pirates Sunday with a 6-5 win. Pirates dropped to 31-19-1 overall, 12-8-1 in league play. The Pirates still in second place in the American Conference. ECU will close out its regular season home schedule on Tuesday when it plays host to Campbell at 6:30. The Pirates with their final series of the year of the regular season this weekend at UCF. But tomorrow night's first pitch against Campbell set for 6:30 senior night for the Pirates and the Fighting Camels. On the links, Jason Day went wire-to-wire at TPC Sawgrass to win the Players' Championship. Day became the first wire-to-wire winner in 16 years at Sawgrass, and he joined Tiger Woods, Johnny Miller, and Tom Watson as the only players to go wire-to-wire twice in the same season, dating back to 1970. The win earned Day $1.89 million, the richest payoff in golf. ECU's men's golf team opens play today as the number 11 seed in the NCAA Regional Championships at the Franklin Regional at the Vanderbilt Legends Club. Pirates, again, are the number 11 seed in today's action. High school baseball from the weekend, D.H. Conley and J.H. Rose both advanced to third round of the North Carolina High School Athletic Association State Baseball Playoffs. Conley will take on New Hanover, and Rose will face Fuquay Varina. Both of those games on Tuesday. Conley's softball team also in third-round play. They will take on West Johnson. And in case you missed it over the weekend, ECU senior track and field jumper Avion Jones not only won gold in the high jump at the American Athletic Conference Outdoor Championships, but he also lofted himself into the realm of the elite athletes in the world. His mark of 2.31 meters represents the second highest of any athlete on the planet this year, while also good enough for the American Athletic Conference meet record and program outdoor record. That's about 7 feet, a little over 7 feet, I guess, when you're high jumping. That's pretty good. It's pretty high.
I saw that video.
It's pretty
amazing.
Have
you seen the video?
I have seen the video.
Unbelievable.
It is. Yeah. That's just running and basically jumping over a Manute Bol,
mm-hmm.
You know, someone who's it's hard to put into words unless you go see the video. It doesn't sound when you read it, doesn't sound that exciting. But go watch the video, you'll see how impressive this is.
It's unbelievable.
It really is.
Yeah.
So
he's an ECU guy, huh?
He is. Yeah. He's a senior. There you go. They always have strong guys.
Is he going to be in the Olympics? I guess he is.
There's a chance he could be. I don't know if he'll be in the Rio Games, but maybe so. Yeah. They start.
Did you see the interview with Michael Phelps last night on 60 Minutes?
No,
it wasn't 60 Minutes. It was the it was the show opposite 60 Minutes on NBC called On Cue something. I don't know, some new show they've got up against 60 Minutes, which was very smart, by the way, because 60 Minutes was all reruns last night, and then at 8 o'clock they did the Morley Safer special, which was about as exciting as watching paint dry.
I watched
that for like 6 seconds, but. I flipped over to NBC, and Matt Lauer had an exclusive interview with Michael Phelps, who talked for the first time about his father. You know how you never heard about his father? So I don't really get the deal with his father. His father was a Maryland highway patrolman, but I guess his relationship with his with Michael's mother was so bad that he became estranged from the family. And so he didn't spend any time with Michael Phelps growing up. And so Michael Phelps admits during this, what we've already heard before, that he ended up going to rehab after the last Olympics.
Right.
And he said he was not gonna swim anymore. He was retired, the whole deal. That was after, where was it, Barcelona? What was the last one? Wasn't it Barcelona?
I forgot now where it was 4 years ago.
Anyway, so wherever the last Olympics was.
Was it Barcelona? That was 92 in Barcelona.
I knew that. So anyway, where were they 4 years?
Wasn't it Brazil?
No, this is Brazil coming up. McGee, Google this. You're just making.
It wasn't Barcelona. I do know that.
I'm not so sure about it. Spain.
My house over the place.
I mean,
for Spain? Maybe it was Spain. We'll check it out.
Isn't Barcelona in Spain? What is wrong? McGee is having a meltdown on the air here.
Now look at my computer. It's freezing up. I can't even Google it.
All right, hang
check
on a
it
second.
Out, Mike Forrest. Hang I can't second. Even
I'm gonna,
I can't even
I'm gonna Google it. Somebody call us quickly. 561-8255. Save us on it. Was it the 2012 Olympics?
2012 Olympics.
2012.
Summer Games. 2012 Summer Games. Were
Summer Games. 2012 Summer Olympics. Here it's coming. It's coming. It was in London.
Yeah.
Michelle Brooks just texted me and said it was. Thank you, Michelle. We
I
knew
remember
that.
Remember that.
Yeah. That's true. Because I had friends that went.
I remember that because of the Dream Team.
Yes.
That's our. Yeah.
So the 2012 Summer Olympiad was in London, and then after that, and I think he won like 6 gold medals in that one, but he revealed that. He refused to practice leading up to it, and his longtime coach, who had coached him since he was 11 years old, they had a huge falling out right before the Summer Olympic Games, and he even said that. That's right. Michelle just reminded me that Lauren Perdue from Greenville got her gold medal there. She swam there. So Michael Phelps said that things got so bad between the two of them that he said, I walked out and gave him the finger.
Oof.
And then the coach responded by giving him the finger back.
Whoa.
So, but now they've made up, and Michael has a new child, and he's actually named his child after the coach.
Okay, there you go.
So it's a storybook. It's a storybook affair.
Yeah,
it's a great story.
You think Russell Wilson gave Tom O'Brien the finger?
I would have, if I had been.
And O'Brien likely gave it back to him.
Yeah. So if you hadn't heard that Russell Wilson audio from the University of Wisconsin graduation over the weekend, we'll play that after the break. How about that?
Sounds good.
Our sports update brought to you by Suddenlink and the Switch and Shout event going on right now. When you make the switch, you get SL200 HD TV, 50 meg internet, and phone service, and it's just $69 a month. Once you've made that switch, buy two, get three, it's only $69. So it's essentially buy two, get one free. Call today and ask about upgrading to an unlimited data plan. Don't wait. Call 866-432-1184 or visit suddenlink.com. And if you need more data and fast data, if you're a gamer or something like that, or you're a big data user, Suddenlink now will give you unlimited data plans if you ask for it. Perfect for people like that. So, check it out at Suddenlink at 866-432-1184. That's 1-866-432-1184. Suddenlink. All right, 9 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. More Talk of the Town on the way. When we come back, if you haven't heard what Russell Wilson said about Tom O'Brien and how he ended up leaving NC State and going to Wisconsin, I'll play that for you next.
During Greenville Toyota's Memorial Markdown Madness, we're giving you more. More selection. More for your trade. More savings. Don't miss our Memorial Day Markdown Madness all month long. At Greenville Toyota, give us 15 minutes. We can lower your payment.
There's a new name in convenience in Eastern North Carolina. All Wilco Hess stores are now Speedway. What makes Speedway different? They understand people's needs. There are many choices out there, but Speedway recognizes that nothing less than outstanding service, a wide selection of products, and a real value for your dollar will attract loyal customers. More than anything, Speedway offers convenience. Come see us at Speedway, serving 22 states in the U.S. and now proud to serve the communities right here in Eastern North Carolina.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Being undaunted is not something ECU fans take lightly. It means never taking a day or season off from showing their true pirate passion through thick and thin. It means gathering to celebrate and cheer the Pirates to victory regardless of life's trials and tribulations. And it means welcoming all types, seasoned veterans to new grads, into the crew to discover the successes ahead. Join the undaunted on the 2016 journey by purchasing your East Carolina football season tickets at ecupirates.com.
During Greenville Toyota's Memorial Markdown Madness, we're giving you more, more savings, and get more with the Greenville Toyota Advantage. Don't miss our Memorial Day Markdown Madness all month long. At Greenville Toyota, give us 15 minutes, we can lower your payment.
Talk of the Town, Monday. Welcome back. It is Monday morning, May the 16th. Good to have everybody here. Temperature is going to be up around 71 degrees today. It is 54 degrees right now in Greenville, 55 in New Bern, and it is 53 degrees in Elizabeth City right now. Welcome back to our Talk of the Town Monday get-together here. Sunny and 71 today. The rain is coming tomorrow. We're looking for cloudy and 57 tonight, and then tomorrow about a 60% chance of rain, which is unfortunate because the last baseball game of the year is tomorrow night. ECU and Campbell. What time is first pitch?
6:30.
And so we're hoping that that will hold on. Because here's the thing: if it gets rained out, would they make it up? They might not, since it's a non-conference game. We were talking about Russell Wilson, who of course left NC State, went and played minor league baseball, and then transferred for his last year of college football eligibility to the University of Wisconsin. And, of course, as we know now, became one of the superstars of the NFL. And for many years, we've been asking the question, how could Tom O'Brien, the NC State head coach, let Russell Wilson get away? And we now know the story. I think this is the first time Russell Wilson has ever publicly told this story. But Saturday, he was speaking as the commencement speaker at his alma mater, the University of Wisconsin. He was the commencement speaker at their graduation exercise. And he actually told the story as part of a motivational thing for the students to say, hey, don't give up on your dreams. Here's Russell Wilson from Saturday's University of Wisconsin graduation.
You don't have to live forever in that no. Because if you know what you're capable of, if you're always prepared, and you keep things in perspective, then life has a way of turning a no into yes. That's what brought me to University of Wisconsin. The summer before my senior year of college, I'm playing minor league baseball. I called my football coach at NC State and say, hey, coach, I'd like to come back for my senior year. And he told me I wasn't coming back. He said, listen, son, you're never going to play in the National Football League. You're too small. There's no chance. You got no shot. Give it up. Of course, I'm on this side of the phone saying, so you're telling me I'm not going to come back to NC State? I won't see the field? He said, no, son, you won't see the field. Now, this was everything I had worked for. And now, it was completely gone. If I wanted to follow my dream, I had to leave NC State. I had no idea if I would get a second chance somewhere else. So, well, the news that I was transferring out went out around 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I'll never forget, I was in Rome, Georgia, playing the Atlanta Braves organization. I wasn't sure what would happen. And then at 4:15, I got a call from the Auburn Tigers. And then I got another call, and another, and another, and another. Most of these coaches had never met me, but it turned out they'd heard about the way I'd handle myself, not just on the field, but off of it as well, during the good times and the bad ones too. In the end, what had started out as the biggest no of my career became the biggest yes of my career.
There it is. Saturday from University of Wisconsin graduation, Russell Wilson. You know, the amazing thing to me about that is that it's clear now. He's taking a shot back at O'Brien and saying, you know, he told me I would never see the field. So, I mean, I don't know how you NC State fans feel about that. Well, you know, of course, Tom O'Brien got fired.
Yeah, but he's now retired. So, you know, Wilson
but
waited.
But, I mean, what was Tom O'Brien thinking? He told Russell Wilson, you can come back, but you're not going to play. I'm not going to play you.
I think it's what he really thought. I think he was never going to make it.
Well, he had the other kid that ended up, you know, being like a backup for Tampa Bay for a couple. What was his name?
Yeah.
He starts with a G.
Mike Glennon.
Yeah, Mike Glennon.
Yeah.
Who was no Russell Wilson. Now Russell Wilson is Russell Wilson.
You know, and that's the motto that NC State doesn't want to have to hear. Obviously, you know, when he said I had to leave NC State to follow my dreams, you know, that's.
Yeah, that's not
I'm
what.
I'm sure
they,
that was kind of a.
Yeah, that's not what
that
they want to hear.
That was a punch in the gut.
That's exactly
that was a punch
right.
in the gut right there.
All right, we're about to leave you now. Everybody have a great Monday. Don't forget, put this on your calendar, Friday morning, Krispy Kreme. We're going to be live on location at Krispy Kreme here in Greenville, and it is the annual Crime Stoppers Radiothon. to raise funds for the Pitt Greenville Crime Stoppers program, a program that we've been involved in for many, many years. Daniel Kennedy, one of our folks here, is on the board. Now my friend Scott Shook chaired that board for many years. Been doing this for a long time. And we're asking businesses in the community or people, individuals, to mark this down on their calendar. Come by, get a free donut at Krispy Kreme on Friday morning. Bring a little something and put in the till for the Crime Stoppers organization, because they do an incredible job and it works. Everybody have a great day.